Babu was, he was a gigantic figure. Now, Naveen was a stranger to Odisha. He would visit his father off and on, but he didn't know Odisha. The fact that Naveen Patnaik does not speak Odia, people may think that it is his disadvantage. I think it is his advantage. It works to his benefit. Take my word, Naveen Patnaik does not consider anyone to be close. Okay, he uses people from time to time. He can extra episode, he remains as a block on Naveen's political campaign. As I see Naveen Patnaik, he is generally a good man who like everyone to be happy and stay well. But when it comes to his political survival or his political benefit, he can also
he can be cruel.
He can be cruel.
नमस्कार, मैं हूं सौरभ द्विवेदी। आप देख रहे हैं लल्लन टॉप का सबसे चिकोलाइट सेक्शन, जिसका नाम है किताब वाला। एक नई किताब, नवीन पटनायक की बायोग्राफी, जिसे लिखा है वरिष्ठ पत्रकार रूबेन बैनर्जी ने। बैनर्जी साहब, आपका बहुत स्वागत है किताब वाला में, और एक पाठक के तौर पे आपको खूब सारा थैंक यू इस किताब को लिखने के लिए। क्योंकि जैसा मैं आपको पहले भी बातचीत में बता रहा था, जब मैं स्टूडेंट था तब मैंने एक इनके ऊपर मोनोग्राम जैसा पढ़ा था कुछ, जो वीर सांगवी ने लिखा था ब्रंच के लिए। और उसके बाद एक उत्सुकता तो पैदा हुई कि एक नेता है जो उड़िया नहीं बोल पाता, लेकिन उड़ीसा का लॉन्गेस्ट सर्विंग चीफ मिनिस्टर है। 18 साल हो गए हैं, 19वां चल रहा है। और एक नेता है जो बहुत प्राइवेट रहता है, एक नेता है जो लगातार चुनाव जीतता है, एक नेता है जो दिल्ली में ज़्यादा दिलचस्पी नहीं लेता है, जबकि पहले वो दिल्ली में ही था, तो उसके बारे में ज़्यादा जानकारी नहीं मिलती। इस किताब ने मेरी उन सारी प्यासों को तृप्त कर दिया, सारी शिकायतों को दूर कर दिया। तो इसके लिए एक रीडर के तौर पे आपको बहुत सारा थैंक यू। कहाँ से ख्याल आया नवीन पटनायक पे किताब लिखने का?
सी, इट वाज इन द मेकिंग फॉर मेनी इयर्स, सेवरल इयर्स रादर।
जी,
लाइक मैं तो उड़ीसा में था, इंडिया टुडे का ही कॉरेस्पॉन्डेंट था, इंडियन एक्सप्रेस में के लिए मैं इंडिया उड़ीसा में था।
जी,
so I used to know Naveen Patnaik, because when Naveen Patnaik first came into politics in 97 and then he became the chief minister in 2000, main Orissa mein kaam kar rahe the as a journalist. I was the India Today correspondent then. So I had access. Then it so happened that in 2003 I left Odisha, I left the country, I went abroad. 12 saal baad main wapas aaya, because I knew lot of people in Odisha. So mera Odisha ke upar thoda focus dhyan tha. But what kept surprising me was that this gentleman was winning election after election, like
yes,
one term, two term, three term. So when I came back into the country in 2015 after 12 saal, I found that so much has changed in my life. But Odisha mein kuch political change aaya hi nahi, wo Naveen Patnaik usi time mein bhi chief minister tha.
Ji,
to main bola ye kaisa ho raha hai? To everyone by then in 2015 everyone had started talking, now Narendra Modi Delhi mein pradhanmantri ban gaya. So everyone was discussing Gujarat model. तो मैं बोला, अरे उड़ीसा में तो और एक सक्सेसफुल मॉडल है, उड़ीसा मॉडल,
उड़ीसा मॉडल,
हाँ, ये तो जीत रहा है। तो बट देन हाउ कम नोबडी हैज रिटन अ बुक? सो देन आई थॉट दैट मे बी आई शुड गेट इन टू इट। सो आई थिंक दिस बुक केम आउट लास्ट ईयर 2018 ऑगस्ट। 2017 आई डिसाइडेड दैट आई विल फिनिश माई बुक, आई विल राइट दिस बुक। सो मैं 3 महीना छुट्टी में चला गया, 2 महीना एग्जैक्टली। सो आई decided that I will write, I traveled, I re-established my contacts. See, lot of what is there in this book was already there in my mind, because almost 60-70% was already there in my mind and in my notebooks.
Achha.
मैं जो reporting जब करते थे, तो notebooks मेरे पास अभी भी है, because they are my precious possession. और दिमाग में था, and the rest I had to update, and so and then I took about around a month to write. The writing part took about a month.
इस किताब की मुझे जो सबसे अच्छी चीज़ लगी वो ये है, ये बोरिंग नहीं है। मतलब हो सकता है ये आपको बहुत ही मिलेनियल वाला स्टेटमेंट लगे, पर बहुत सारी पॉलिटिकल बायोग्राफीज़ के साथ ये दिक्कत आती है पढ़ते हुए कि वो बीच में बहुत ही, मैं अपने JNU की लैंग्वेज में कहूँ तो बड़ी झिलाऊ सी हो जाती हैं, बहुत ज्ञान देने लगती है।
आई एग्री विथ यू, बिकॉज बिफोर आई गॉट इन टू दिस राइटिंग दिस बुक आई हैव रेड लॉट ऑफ अदर बायोग्राफीज। देर हैव बीन गुड बायोग्राफीज रिटन इन इंडिया, देर हैव बीन बैड बायोग्राफीज रिटन इन इंडिया। जनरली मैं बोल सकता हूँ दैट बायोग्राफिक लिखने के टाइम पे क्या होता है, लाइक biography writing is also an art. Not that I am a PhD in biography writing. This is the only biography I have written. By the way, it's an unauthorized biography. I did not take permission from Naveen Patnaik to write this book.
Which is good. Pressure nahi raha hoga.
Haan, usi liye to. Nahi to otherwise I would have been under pressure. Hagiography ban jata. To wo nahi kiya. Janbuch ke nahi kiya. To main ye manta hu. Aap, I am sahmat hu aapse. The biography, most of the time when you write a biography, it becomes very boring and academic. Theory jada ho jata hai. But I being a journalist lifelong, I wanted to tell a story. So I've kept it. I deliberately said like I'll make it very conversational and anecdotal.
Yes.
Bahut sare anecdotes honge, stories hoga. And that is how the narrative I have kept. I have deliberately kept that narrative. It should read like a fiction.
So let's start with anecdotes then. Jo pehla anecdote mujhe is kitab ka yaad aa raha hai. Aur, जिससे किताब शुरू भी होती है वो असका में इलेक्शन है, बाय इलेक्शन है, और कैसे ये बीजू पटनायक की डेथ के बाद फैमिली में डिस्कशन हो रहा है, दिलीप रे के घर पे डिस्कशन हो रहा है कि कौन चुनाव लड़ेगा. देन ही वॉक्स इन कि अच्छा आप लोग नहीं जा रहे हैं, प्रेम नहीं जा रहे हैं, बीजू बाबू के बड़े बेटा और बेटी नहीं जा रहे हैं तो मैं जाऊँगा. और फिर आपने इसमें लिखा है कैसे वो हर जगह एक ही वो जो दो लाइन थे वो दोहराते थे. वो पंक्तियाँ आप व्यूअर्स को बताएं और क्या उनका असर होता था, बीजू बाबू की क्या लेगेसी थी, वहाँ से मैं शुरू करना चाहता हूँ.
सी आई इंसिडेंटली आई टू करेक्ट दिस, दैट वाज नॉट द फर्स्ट एनेक्डोट. द बुक स्टार्ट्स विद एन एनेक्डोट. माय फर्स्ट मीटिंग विद नवीन पटनायक इन 1988. बीजू पटनायक थे, ही वॉज द लीडर ऑफ अपोजिशन. नवीन पटनायक वॉज अ सोशलाइट एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम.
कॉफी टेबल बुक वगैरह.
हाँ, वो तो तीन कॉपी किताब लिखे है, एक फिल्म में भी एक्टिंग किया है, डिसीवर.
एक फिल्म में भी एक्टिंग की.
हाँ, इट वाज अ बिट रोल, छोटा रोल. आईवरी मर्चेंट का फिल्म है.
आईवरी, अच्छा वो है.
डीसी वाज. आई हैड फर्स्ट मेट नवीन पटनायक ब्रीफली. मैं कोणार्क में गए थे घूमने के लिए, फॉर देयर वाज एन ओकेशन एंड बीजू बाबूज प्राइवेट सेक्रेटरी हैड टेकन मी देयर.
यस.
सो उसी टाइम में हम लोग घूम रहे थे तो सडनली दिस बीजू बाबूज प्राइवेट सेक्रेटरी, ही वाज रोमिंग अराउंड. ही सेड यू नो दिस गाय? आई सेड नो, ही इज बीजू बाबूज यंगेस्ट सन. सो नवीन पटनायक वाज वेयरिंग जीन्स एंड टी शर्ट. He was 48, 49. He came and we shook hands. He said, "Hi, I'm Naveen." I said, "Hi, I'm a reporter with Indian Express, whatever." So that is where it ended. And then when he came back into, then I met him after 88. I took him very lightly. Theek hai, Biju Babu san, I forgot about it. 97, he was in politics because Biju Babu's dehant ho gaya. And then the party needed someone. They needed a mascot because they were very senior leaders at that point of time. But they thought that we are very important, very senior leaders. All that we need to rule is a mascot. Jo Biju Babu ka sympathy will collect the sympathy that exists for Biju Babu. To Naveen Patnaik politics mein aa gaya. 97, to obviously he won. Biju Babu ka sympathy tha. He was Biju Babu san. People, see, he never spoke Odia even now. He doesn't speak Odia now. He did not speak Odia then. It did not matter to Odias in Odisha because for them, he was Biju Babu's son, and that was the only criteria. He won three consecutive parliamentary elections, 97, 98, 99. 2000 mein election ho raha tha, assembly. Everyone knew that Biju Janta Dal, by then he had floated his party, he will win. They will win because Congress chose Sarkar thi, UC time, it was very unpopular at that point of time. So it so happened that he was campaigning Naveen as an aspiring chief minister.
Yes.
And I had access. I was at, by then, I was the India Today correspondent in Odisha. So, ek din hua, like he was traveling on a helicopter, so I would go off and on with his on his helicopter. So, that was very funny in the sense, it was a four-seater helicopter. Pilot baithe hai, Naveen saamne mein baithe hai, main peeche hai aur uska ek secretary baitha tha. So, we were going around from one place to place. So, I remember like wo baitha hai udhar, so we land say in a place called Thakur Munda, which is a very small town in Mayurbhanj. Now, Naveen was a stranger to Orissa. He would visit his father off and on, but he didn't know Orissa, right? So obviously, he did not know where Thakur Munda is. He would not have even heard the name of Mayurbhanj, possibly, the district. So his people had given him all these slips. Number one, number two, number three, kidhar kidhar meeting hai, wo is serial order mein. So number one slip aya, he will take it off from his pocket. Thakur Munda bada bada karke le gaya, so he'll okay, Thakur Munda.
Pronounce it.
Then he lands to the dais. Mere pitaji ne bola tha Thakur Munda, unka bahut pyara hai. People will go ecstatic. Arey, Biju Babu ke liye Thakur Munda bahut pyara tha. Theek hai. But these were killer lines. Okay, like he had rehearsed these lines, two or three lines, but they had a fantastic effect. As it is, people were very, very receptive to him. And then when he says, "Mere pitaji ne bola tha, thakur, unke liye pyar, thakur munda bahut pyara tha," people went ballistic. Then, "Mere pitaji ne aur bhi bola tha, beta, thakur munda jarur jana." People were bowled over. Oh, wow. Clap, clap, clap. So people went ecstatic. And then, apart from all these two or three lines, Naveen had to say nothing. He'll just wave, namaskar, and he'll go off. Second place that we were landing, I think it was Kendrapara. So another slip comes out, Kendrapara, Kendrapara, Kendrapara. He rehearses it, goes, says the same lines. Mere pitaji ne bola tha, Kendrapara unke liye bahut pyara tha. Then again, mere pitaji ne bola tha, beta, jarur Kendrapara jana. Fantastic effect. Okay, so he swept the state just as say,
मेरे बाबूजी ने बोला था
हो गया and nobody questioned कब बोला था क्या बोला था but the point is see elections is all about connecting he connected with people
a
winning narrative and that was a fantastic narrative and nobody questioned actually whether Biju Babu said all this or who cared and nobody cared
sir my question is कि Biju Patnaik he's a legend politically बहुत successful नहीं दिखते हैं लेकिन ही इज अ लेजेंड तो क्या था जो उनको लेजेंड बनाता था
नहीं बिकॉज दैट वाज बीजू बाबूज पर्सनैलिटी वाज सच
टॉल
ही वुड टॉक बिग ही एक्ट बिग असर्टिव ही हैड अ बिग हार्ट
जैसे वो आपने वीपी सिंह की वो रैली वाला जिक्र किया वो बताया
ही आल्सो हैड अ वेरी बिग हार्ट बीजू बाबू वाज ही वाज अ जाइगेंटिक फिगर एंड हिज एक्सप्लॉइट्स इवन एज एन एयरफोर्स पायलट and the kind of things that he did. So over the generations, like they had become his exploits. Biju Babu was part of Odia folklore. Like any ordinary Odia would aspire to be Biju Patnaik. Like that would be their biggest dream. That
pilot, freedom fighter, industry leader.
He knows everyone, he can talk, he can catch hold of anyone by the shoulder and then talk to them. Like he was the, so and in locally he used to be known as the Kolingo Shondo, the Kolingo Bull, right? So and it was a
Kalinka Sand.
Kalinka Sand, yeah. So he was folklore. Very charismatic. Which I have described that Naveen yes. possibly is more politically successful, but he may not match Biju Babu's charisma even now. But the tragedy with Biju Patnaik was that despite his image and his figure and his personality, say if you consider that Biju Babu had 50 years of political life, out of that only 9 years he was in power. Whereas this gentleman, Naveen Patnaik, he has been in politics for now 20 years, 21 years. He has been in power for 20 years. Always he has been actually been in power. He has never been on opposition. The first election he was an MP, 97. And 98 onwards he has been an MP and then a minister in Vajpayee's government. Yes. From 2000 he has been a chief minister. So he has never been in opposition. So he has surpassed Biju Babu. Despite Biju Babu being Biju Babu.
इसमें किताब में जिक्र आता है कि एक धड़ा था जो बीजू बाबू को लगातार जनता दल में कमजोर कर रहा था और उड़ीसा से चार सांसद जीत के आते चार सीटें दो सीटों पर तो बीजू बाबू जीतते हैं दो और इसके बावजूद वो बीजू पटनायक जो बड़ा कद्दावर नेता थे वही सरकार में जो संयुक्त मोर्चे की सरकार बनती है यूनाइटेड फ्रंट की मंत्री नहीं बन पाते हैं क्या अरिथमेटिक रही थी
एज वॉज ऑल्सो कैचिंग अप सी दैट्स अ ट्रेजेडी विद बीजू पटनायक आई ऑलवेज फेल गिवन इज स्टैचर गिवन इज पर्सनैलिटी हीज एंडिंग वॉज इन दैट रियली इट वॉज प्रिटी सैड चार सीटें जीते उसके दो तो एंड ही हिमसेल्फ वॉज का हैड कॉन्टेस्टेड फ्रॉम कटक एंड आस्का तो एंड ही डिड नॉट हैव द नंबर्स बट कम टू थिंक ऑफ इट इफ बीजू पटनायक हैड द नंबर्स डू यू थिंक देवेगौड़ा वुड हैव बिकम द प्राइम मिनिस्टर देन इन 95 96 नो देवेगौड़ा बिकम द प्राइम मिनिस्टर विद आई थिंक 16 एमपीज और 17 एमपीज ही बीजू पटनायक हैड 17 और 18 कंपेयर देवेगौड़ा'स पर्सनैलिटी एंड बीजू बाबू वुड हैव बीन द फर्स्ट क्लेमेंट टू बी द प्राइम मिनिस्टर बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली इन दैट इलेक्शन ही डिड नॉट हैव द नंबर्स 96 एंड ही कट अ सॉरी फिगर एंड बाई देन ही वॉज गेटिंग ओल्ड एंड There were others in the party within his janta dal in Odisha who he himself had groomed, but they had become ambitious by then. And like? Srikanjana and others. Okay. So they had their own ambitions. And then they played. Politics is all about climbing up the ladder. So yes. They did that. So you can't generally actually hold it against them. That is the nature of the yes. trade. And that is what they did. They became ministers. Biju Babu was sidelined. And that is also possibly one, that definitely is one reason why Oriyas generally felt very upset and angry. So when the chance came, they voted for Naveen Patnaik in 2000.
That Odisha identity.
No, they thought, they realized that Biju Babu has been wronged. And when Biju Babu died in 97, his body was taken to Odisha and his cremation took place in Puri, Swargadhar. Odisha had never witnessed such a thing. See, Biju Babu at that point of time was out of power. He had not even become a minister in Delhi. There were 5 lakh people and nobody organized that crowd. Those people came out spontaneously and Odisha had never seen such a turnout. 5 lakh people in Bhubaneswar is unbelievable. And that is what happened because people generally felt that he has been wronged. And they came out, they actually felt saddened by Biju Babu's death. And they also had a guilt feeling because they had defeated Biju Babu's government in 1995. They wanted to teach him a lesson, but they did not think that he will actually lose.
And J.B. Patnaik
and J.B. Patnaik will come back. So, lot of other things worked. There were other factors. So, when the earliest opportunity came, they all did amends by voting in his son.
Pramod Mahajan ka kya role tha Biju Janta Dal ke banne mein? Kyunki Janta Dal ka ek dhada BJP mein merger ke liye tayyar tha. Lekin fir merger nahi hua.
Wohi to main likha hu that if that faction had, there were two factions. One faction wanted a regional party because historically Odisha mein ek regional party ka space hai.
Kabhi Utkal Congress, kabhi kuch.
Jan Congress hai. Abhi bhi hai. Right. Biju Janta Dal hai. Maybe shayad aur ek regional party ke liye bhi abhi tayyari chal raha hai. And I think there will be a regional party in Odisha.
Okay. Panda ke netritv mein?
Ho sakta hai. Okay. But there will be a regional party because there is a space. Okay. So, and then there was another group within that Janta Dal, Biju Babu's Janta Dal, which wanted to join BJP because BJP was on the ascendant then.
Yes.
Advani ka Ratha Jatra hua, Vajpayee's popularity was at its peak. And so when they were working on this, so they realized that they don't have money because as a new regional outfit, who will fund? You need resources. So BJP, then finally they decided that we will not join BJP. If they had joined BJP, Naveen Patnaik could have ended up as Orissa, president of Orissa unit of BJP, Bharatiya Janata Party. That did not happen. But when that did not happen, when the majority of the Janata Dal workers and the party leaders thought that, okay, we will have our own regional party, BJP thought, we don't exist in Odisha. They had a very negligible presence, right? They never had a toehold into that state. They said, we will bankroll you, we will help you, we will give you money, and so we can have an alliance. So we get a entry into the state, and that is what exactly happened. When the first rally took place, Biju Janata Dal was found, the foundation, the party was launched. Shatrughan Sinha and I think Shahir Singh Varma and maybe Pramod Mahajan were also there. So they were physically present and they had definitely given money to the party. And that is why they worked together, they had an alliance and then that alliance continued till 2009.
Till 2009. Naveen Patnaik ke bare mein jo bahut sari kahaniyan kitab mein zikr hai, logon ke beech zikr hai. उसमें एक चीज़ ये है जिसका आपने भी अभी बखान किया कि उन्होंने अपनी पर्सनल इमेज को बहुत बचा के रखा है ना, कि लोग मंत्रियों से नाराज़ हो सकते हैं. अभी कुछ दिनों पहले एक मंत्री को फायर किया, 2-4 रोज़ पहले. उसके पहले वो ब्राह्मणों पे कमेंट पे किया, अस्पताल में आग लगी तो किया. तो नवीन पटनायक जो उड़िया नहीं बोलते हैं, बहुत ज़्यादा पब्लिक कॉन्टैक्ट भी नहीं करते हैं कि पदयात्रा कर रहे हैं कुछ, हाउ डिड ही मैनेज दिस?
सी, आई हैव अ थ्योरी. That the fact that Naveen Patnaik does not speak Odia, people may think that it is his disadvantage. I think it is his advantage. It works to his benefit.
Okay.
Because I have a theory and I am pretty convinced about this theory of mine. In fact, main mazak mein Naveen Patnaik ji ko bhi pehle kaha hu ye. I had access to him as the India Today correspondent. Main kabhi kabhi chala jata tha uske ghar mein breakfast karne ke liye, chai peene ke liye. So, see. You must realize why did Odias embrace Naveen Patnaik so spontaneously? Because the other politicians in the state were so discredited. People used to hate them. Now here was a guy who was not in politics, Biju Babu's son, who was away from Odisha. He suddenly comes. He did not look and act and talk like any other discredited politician. The fact that he did not speak the local language actually benefited him, because for an ordinary Odia, he said, "Arey, ye to aur koi compromise politician ka jaisa nahi hai. Ye to very innocent hai. Ye to hamara language bhi bol nahi sakta hai." So that actually it helped to the bonding. And now, even now, that he does not speak the local language, it sets him apart as a politician. That I am not like any other politician. I am different. See, his entire USP is, I am not like anybody else. I am different. I am Naveen Patnaik. And maybe if he starts speaking in Odia, which I believe he now understands and can speak, because he has spent 18 years in that state. There is no way he cannot speak this language, because the language is pretty easy to master. Okay. I think it's a deliberate political strategy that he still wants to retain that I am a different kind of a person. I am a different politician. I am not as compromised or tainted as any other politician.
Family ko bhi involved nahi rakhte hain, wo sab bhi.
He doesn't have. He has no family.
But he is ruthless. और उसकी शुरुआत हो जाती है कि जो उनकी पार्टी के कार्यकारी अध्यक्ष हैं, उन्हीं का पर्चा लास्ट टाइम पे गड़बड़ हो जाता है. तो ये क्या है नवीन पटनायक स्टाइल ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स की, जो बहुत करीब दिखता है, बहुत ताकतवर दिखता है, फिर वो चाहे प्यारी मोहन हो, चाहे उसके पहले के लीडर्स हो, और एकदम से ही कट देम शॉर्ट.
हैविंग सीन एंड स्टडीड नवीन पटनायक स्टाइल ऑफ ऑपरेशन फॉर सो मेनी इयर्स क्लोजली, आई हैव कम टू द कंक्लूजन दैट there is no one who can claim to be actually close to him. There are people who will claim that I am very close to him, but take my word, Naveen Patnaik does not consider anyone to be close. Okay, he uses people from time to time, and those people will keep changing. His coterie keeps changing. X, Y could be replaced by Y and Z, and those people at that point of time, for a period of time, might say that we are very close and Naveen is very close. But as far as my understanding, Naveen uses them. He is not close to anyone, and he discards them as and when it's needed. It's use and throw policy, which he uses, which he has used to the hilt for his political advantage. And his political career is replete with such examples. Like, it started with Vijay Mahapatra, Nalini Mohanty, Dilip Rai, people who thought that they were close to him, the people who thought that they are his mentors.
Yes, okay, people like Dilip Roy.
Nalini Mohanty.
Biju Babu, aakhri dino mein Dilip Roy ke hi bangle pe the.
Dilip Roy ghar pe the. So, but then Naveen, see, that you must give credit to his political acumen.
Yes.
Because he realized that in politics, if I have to survive, I have to cut down all my potential threats. So, he has been very, very, clinical about it. Like, whether he is close to me or he is friends with me, like Jai Panda.
Yes, Jai Panda. To come to
Jai that. Panda was his close friend. They used to drink together. Okay, I have written that. Okay. And then the moment he thought that Jai Panda can become larger than me, he has taken him out of the equation. And
what went wrong between them?
No, I will tell you why Jai Panda, he has gone after Jai Panda. I am not surprised, because Jai Panda, Jai Panda is hurt that Naveen has discarded him or gone against him, and certain things that have happened as possibly should not have happened. But it doesn't really surprise me, because you must realize Jai Panda, as an MP, as an industrialist, his family is a big industrialist family in Odisha, one of the topmost, the pioneer industrialist family of the state. His wife runs OTV, which is the number one television channel in Odisha. Like, if you are on OTV, you have reached every Odisha household. It's that popular, right? So he has access to the media. He has money, he is an industrial family in Delhi, he has connections, he knows everyone, he is very well networked. That's a deadly combination for Naveen Patnaik, right?
Yes.
He can become
and
a threat.
And he has age.
And he has age, so he can become his threat. He has taken him out of his equation. Now Jai Panda can say, I am very hurt. But from Naveen's perspective, it's possibly the right thing to do, right? But the way he has done it, possibly he shouldn't have done it. But there is a logic. Naveen doesn't do anything without any rational. He is a cool, calculated, shrewd political operator. And I am not surprised with the way what he has done to Jai Panda. And in fact, I keep saying, and I have said this even in an OTV interview, that there will be more such cases. People who possibly are seen to be very close to Naveen Patnaik today will also be possibly...
Like Pyarimohan?
No, Pyarimohan Patro is dead.
Previously, like Pyarimohan,
there will be more. There will,
shunted him
no,
out.
No, there will be more such examples. Hmm. People who now think that they are very close to Naveen Patnaik, wait and see. Naveen Patnaik will also throw them out. Most likely.
किताब में भी जिक्र है और भी सुनने में आया कि जय पांडा को बाहर करने की एक वजह ये भी थी कि ओटीवी नवीन बाबू की सेहत के बारे में खबरें फैला रहा था.
That is what,
और ये बहुत चर्चा होती है नवीन पटनायक की हेल्थ को लेकर.
That is what the allegation is and the allegation has been that it was जय पांडा who floated these rumors about his health. That he will have to have a kidney transplant, he is on dialysis and all that. There is no basis to it. As of now, I am more or less convinced that those reports are not true. He is not in the best of health, that's for sure. But dialysis kidney transplant may not be necessarily correct. Okay. And I've spoken to Jay Panda because when I was writing this book, I had sat down with Jay Panda also. I've spoken to many people. And Jay Panda has categorically denied having any role to play in behind these rumors. And which I will accept. But there was suddenly a disconnect between the two. They were, I wouldn't say they were friends, but they were social companions. Because Naveen Patnaik, when he went
drinking
to...
Drinking partner.
Let's... drinking is again a very personal
okay.
choice.
Haan,
no, but...
That
but
shows the comfort as well.
No, no, because...
A person
no,
like Naveen, if he's comfortable...
No, no, because, see, come to think of it, Naveen has gone from Delhi, from a cocktail circuit, social circuit. He goes to live in Bhubaneswar. He needs people who can speak in his own, his accented English,
yes.
right? Who knows how to hold a glass.
Yes.
He doesn't have too many people in Bhubaneswar.
Yes.
So he gravitated to one or two people like Jay Panda. And they were his social companions,
yes.
right? You need friends to survive, right? So Jay Panda was pretty close to him. And we all know you knew about it. But I'm again reiterating, I'm not very surprised that Naveen has discarded him because he possibly saw, he definitely saw in Jay
the potential threat. But about Naveen Babu's health then? Because wo 15 August ya 26 January ka function tha, bolne ke liye khade hue,
achanak se baith gaye. That was 2 years ago. He,
yeah.
That was a case of dehydration. He blacked out and he couldn't continue with his speech, and which I mentioned that. See, he is not getting any younger. He is 72, going to be 73. He has acute spondylitis. There are other ailments he suffers from. A couple of years back, he fell down and he hurt himself very badly. And then there are apparently other ailments that he's... And he doesn't, when I see him now, like I've not met him in recent times, I've seen him in public rallies and all. He looks pretty unwell. He looks pretty unwell. He takes time even to get out of his car and get into the car. He takes 5 minutes. So there is, I would like to say that, I would like to believe that there is cause for concern, but it's health and we must respect his, it's a privacy and all that. So we shouldn't be speculating on his health. I would wish him good health and...
Yes, everyone should. But Naveen ki legacy ko, kaun aage badhayega? Arun Patnaik, unke bhatije, ya party se hi koi vyakti aayega? Kyunki ye regional parties mein ek bada masla hota hai. बाकी पार्टियों में क्या होता है कि साहब बेटा बेटी होते हैं, पर नवीन पटनायक ने तो शादी नहीं की, तो ऐसे में ये सवाल और बड़ा हो जाता है.
सी द ओरिसा फ्यूचर पोस्ट नवीन सिनेरियो आफ्टर नवीन वी कैन ओनली स्पेकुलेट. इसको तो कोई रेडीमेड फॉर्मूला है नहीं. वन पॉसिबिलिटी कुड बी दैट अरुण पटनायक हिज नेफ्यू बड़ा भाई का बेटा प्रेम पटनायक सन ही कुड बी अ वायबल बिकॉज सम पीपल विद इन द पार्टी वुड लाइक अरुण
पटनायक थिंग
Patnaik, the biju babu, Naveen Patnaik,
yes.
sympathy, ek sympathy wave, whatever, so they would like to have a mascot. And will Arun Patnaik be as politically savvy, cunning as his uncle to survive in this world? One doesn't know. So that is one possibility. The other possibility is that quite a bit of it would also depend on 2019 results. Like say suppose BJP, there are 147 assembly seats. Now, in 2019 assembly, BJP wins, so BJP wins. BJP is in power. Okay. But say suppose BJP gets about 40 to 45 seats. They don't win, but they have a sizable number of MLAs.
Yes.
Then in absence, see, touch wood, in the case of, God forbid, if Naveen exits from the political stage, then BJP will be within striking distance by splitting BJD
yes.
and from their government. But then for that they need 40, 45, 50 MLAs in 2019. If they are, say, get 10 or 15, then it may not happen that way. They may not be able to win away BJD, MLAs into that side and form a government. Another possibility would be, so a lot depends on 2019 results. Okay. Another possibility, you see, as I said, in Odisha, there has always been a space for regional party. There are enough number of leaders who have fallen out over a period of time with Naveen Patnaik and the ruling establishment, who are sitting at home. Okay. They are also equally wily, very veteran, experienced politicians. They might come together and float a regional political party with a new slogan. All that they need is a new narrative, yes, which they have to connect and sell. What is lacking now is a narrative. Someone has to come up with a new narrative which connects with the people. Odisha now needs a narrative. See, all said and done, I would like to say that Naveen, even after 18 years in power, he is not a hated figure, unlike other incumbent chief ministers. People may not like him, people may dislike him, people may be disenchanted or disillusioned with him, all that is possible. But he is still not hated. So that is his biggest achievement. But there is a growing sense of, you know, like, ये बहुत साल हो गया मैंने इट्स गॉन ऑन फॉर टू लॉन्ग 18 इयर्स
रोटी पलट देनी चाहिए जैसा छत्तीसगढ़ में सुना
हां वन टर्म टू मेनी
एमपी में सुना
हां सो इट्स बेसिकली वन टर्म टू मेनी सो मे बी अ न्यू नैरेटिव अ न्यू रीजनल पार्टी माइट क्लिक अ न्यू फेस माइट क्लिक अ लॉट वुड डिपेंड ऑन द 2019 रिजल्ट्स
नवीन पटनायक के बारे में जब बात करते हैं बहुत सारे उनके पर्सनैलिटी के एस्पेक्ट्स के बारे में बात करते हैं तो एक कीवर्ड बार बार दिमाग में आता है वेंजेंस इज वेरी रूथलेस आपने एक पुलिस कॉप का जिक्र किया हु वॉज DGP
प्रकाश मिश्रा
क्लोज टू नवीन एट वन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम
ही वॉज इज डीजीपी
थे एंड देन थिंग्स गो बैड 2014 के इलेक्शन में उसके बाद जब उनको यहाँ CBI में लाने की तैयारी चल रही थी तो जबरदस्ती का केस दाखिल कर दिया कोर्ट से फटकार खाई फिर जिस अधिकारी को फटकार मिली उसको DGP बना दिया ये क्या ट्रेट है नवीन
आई थिंक दैट पर्टिकुलर एपिसोड पीके मिश्रा एपिसोड ही रिमेन्स एज अ ब्लॉट ऑन नवीन्स पॉलिटिकल कैरियर इवन कम टू थिंक ऑफ इट एंड आई हैव बीन सेइंग दिस आई हैव बीन मिसअंडरस्टूड बाय नवीन एंड हिज पीपल हु आर क्लोज टू हिम नाउ बट आई हैव ऑलवेज फेल्ट दैट मे बी ही हैड टू डू दिस टू सर्वाइव पॉलिटिकली बट वॉट ही डिड वॉज पॉसिबली अनएथिकल सी ही His entire positioning, branding is, I am very clean, I am very honest.
Yes.
But at the same time, though he has retained his clean image, he has dirtied his hands with some of the most macabre, manipulative political machinations that one can think of. Like even the way he deprived Bijay Mahapatra, his working committee chairman, yes, the PAC chairman, head of his ticket, that was very immoral.
Back
it was,
in
2000, it was very unethical. True. Okay, if anyone who knows the story knows that it's very
unethical. The way he shunted him
out. And it has never happened in Indian history, electoral political history.
Yes.
Right. What he did with P.K. Mishra, very unfair and it leaves a very bitter taste in mouth. So, but then that is him because...
And probably it's a message to the bureaucracy as well, fall in line and stay loyal.
For him, as I see Naveen Patnaik, he's generally a good man. Who like everyone to be happy and stay well, but when it comes to his political survival or his political benefit, he can be cruel.
किताब में बहुत जगह जिक्र है कि जब नवीन पटनायक अपनी पहली असेंबली जीत के नतीजे सुन रहे थे तो आप उनके साथ थे और भी कई मौकों पर थे यू हैड एक्सेस एज यू एडमिटेड योर सेल्फ ये बुक आने के बाद आपकी नवीन पटनायक से बात हुई व्हाट्स हिज रिएक्शन
नो आई हैव नॉट मेट हिम I met him last before the book was done and after the book came out I had gone to his office he was not there but his coterie close I have been in touch with they have been discussing with me they were very curious and apprehensive that main kitab mein kya likh dunga kya nahi likhunga I would like to believe that they were 50-50 like it was 50% happy 50% because there are lots of good things about Naveen Patnaik in this
yes,
book
and good there and bad
good and there are bad things about him
yes.
So they were very sporting and I must acknowledge that they said like it's a 50-50 book I think you have done a very credible job and we are happy so
matlab koi agenda nahi dikhta kitab mein jo cheeze jaisi hain achhi cheeze bhi batayi gayi hain
nahi what has happened is possibly both sides are unhappy okay they because नवीन पटनायक फॉलोअर्स ऑफ नवीन पटनायक जैसे ये तो नेगेटिव बातें भी आप छाप दिए है ठीक है सो दे आर स्लाइटली अनहैप्पी एंड द अदर द ऑपोजिशन आप तो नवीन को भी थोड़ा ऊपर हीरो बना दिया वो भी ठीक नहीं हुआ सो आई हैव लॉस्ट फ्रेंड्स ऑन बोथ साइड्स एंड आई एम हैप्पी बिकॉज इफ बोथ साइड्स आर अनहैप्पी देन दैट मीन्स आई हैव बीन राइट
यू अर्न रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ रीडर्स लाइक मी
That's the ultimate acknowledgement that I can get.
One last question. Everyone is talking about 2019 and for BJP 2019 election is very important. In which direction they'll turn? Will it be the continuity of Modi legacy and Modi brand of politics? Aur un sari cheezon mein Mission Coromandel ka baar baar zikr ho raha hai. East Coast ki wo 147 seat hai. और उसमें भी ओडिशा की 22 सीट है
21
तो माफ कीजिए 21 सीट है जिसमें अभी बीजेपी के पास एक सीट है जो एलोरम की बाकी 20 शंख वाली पार्टी के पास है खबरें ये भी आ रही हैं कि शायद प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी दो सीटों से चुनाव लड़ने की परंपरा को कंटिन्यू रखते हुए पूरी की सीट से या किसी और सीट से
चुनाव मे नॉट बी ट्रू
पर काफी पॉपुलर है ये रूमर तो ओडिशा में क्या अभी बीजेपी की क्या तैयारियां आपको नजर आ रही है आपने काफी विस्तार से लिखा भी है धर्मेंद्र प्रधान बहुत एक्टिव है पंचायत चुनाव में बीजेपी की परफॉर्मेंस काफ़ी सुधरी है क्या इनके लिए संभावना है ओडिशा में
आई वुड स्टिल से सी फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम एवर नवीन पटनायक विल कम अप अगेंस्ट अ क्लोज कॉन्टेस्ट अ टफ इलेक्टोरल कॉन्टेस्ट ऑल दीज डेज इट वॉज काइंड ऑफ अ वॉक ओवर फॉर हिम फॉर वेरियस रीजन्स कांग्रेस एग्जिस्टेंस में नहीं था 2014 में मोदी हवा चल रहा था पूरा इंडिया में बट उड़ीसा में बीजेपी का कोई ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल स्ट्रक्चर ही नहीं था देर आर 36,000 पोलिंग बूथ्स हाफ ऑफ देम बीजेपी कुड नॉट इवन सेंड अ रिप्रेजेंटेटिव देर सो दे वर नॉन एग्जिस्टेंट ऑन द ग्राउंड
इन 2014
इवन इन 2014 इवन एट द टाइम व्हेन मोदी वेव वाज एट द स्ट्रांगेस्ट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम एवर नाउ नवीन विल कम अप अगेंस्ट अ टफ कॉन्टेस्ट बिकॉज दे हैव अ वेरी ऑर्गेनाइज रोबस्ट ऑपोजिशन बिकॉज बीजेपी हैज set its house in order okay and following this panchayat election results which happened 1.5 years 2 years ago BJP has come out as a second as the principal opposition to biju janta dal congress is now relegated to the third spot post panchayat result the momentum was with BJP because they had emerged as number 2 in the state The challenge now is, see, Dharmendra Pradhan all of a sudden, he's very hardworking. He's touring the state every second day, he's back in Odisha, he's campaigning, this, that. But he has a tall task in hand because it's, who is he trying to match up, measure up to? Naveen Patnaik. And Naveen Patnaik has reached a kind of a, he has attained a kind of an aura, a charisma, which is very difficult to measure up because that is something which Naveen has acquired over a period of 18 years. Now this gentleman, Dharmendra Pradhan, who is relatively younger, now you can't expect him to acquire that kind of charisma overnight. Though Oriyas are generally very proud of the fact that an Oriya boy has made it this big in Delhi. Because in, come to think
part of Modi coterie, Modi cabinet, Amisha.
Odisha has never had such an influential cabinet minister ever. Yes. Ever. Biju Babu was also a cabinet minister. He was steel and mines. Okay. But this gentleman is
petroleum minister, Ujjula Yojana.
Exactly. You know? So Odisha has never had such an influential minister, cabinet. So there is a matter of pride. But will the pride factor translate into votes? That is Pradhan's challenge. And also a lot would depend on how Modi's popularity graph is looking in 2019. If Modi is doing very well, there it will have a effect in Odisha. If Modi is going down in the rest of the country, that will also dampen BJP's prospects in Odisha. So it's, I would still say, because as I keep going back to the same thing, that Naveen is still not a hated figure. He's still not hated. People may be unhappy, upset. There might be grievances.
So a very strong anti-incumbency against
Naveen.
Oh,
tipping point mere ko abhi bhi nahi dikh raha. You ask me like I
the way it was for JB and then
tipping point abhi if it is happening I have not been able to see it okay maybe it will happen I don't know there is still 3 months as on today BJP will definitely do better than what they did last time but I would still say Naveen has his nose ahead in the race
at some point of time they were friends
till 2009
BJP and BJD
yeah
what went wrong
no again as I said, Naveen's use and throw, use your colleague and then discard. So he needed BJP. When the party Biju Janta Dal was formed, he needed BJP for resources and everything, right? And in 2000, he was becoming the chief minister for the first time, so he was not very sure. He needed BJP as an ally. BJP was already in Delhi, in center, okay? In 2004, he again won an election. He still had BJD. In his second term, towards the end of his second time, he had come onto his own self. He was very confident. He knew by and large.
That
he
survey
knew.
Thing.
Survey
and
to ho
gaya.
So now he knew that I can discard. I have used BJP. Now I can discard BJP. So he discarded BJP. Yeah, that is what I keep telling about Naveen Patnaik. That is the beauty of Naveen Patnaik's politics. He uses people and discards people. Politically, you'll have to do it.
Sure.
You may criticize him, but then that is what the nature of politics is. That is what politics is all about.
And at the end of the day, is it the possibility that if NDA, if Narendra Modi needs Biju Janata Dal's support post 2019 results, because he is very critical of Congress as well. He clearly said 2 days back, I won't be part of Mahagathbandhan.
I was reading somewhere, a friend of mine, in fact my colleague has written yesterday or day before, and I liked it. The expression that he used is Naveen Patnaik sab bolta hai, that he keeps equidistance from everyone. It's not equidistance, you look at it the other way. Equi proximity with others. So he is in
not equal proximity.
Equi proximity. I like that. Actually it is. So ho sakta hai. Absolutely, why not? He was part of NDA. Right. What stops him from going back to NDA? There is no huge ethical issues or
Muslim vote bhi bahut zyada nahi, 1-2% hi hai.
2% hai. So that's negligible. So that doesn't matter. So ho hi sakta hai.
What next, Mr. Ruben Banerjee, after this Naveen Patnaik biography? Expectations are high. आप 84 से journalist हैं, मतलब मैं एक साल का था तब से आप पत्रकारिता कर रहे हैं और इतने सारे states में आपने bureau संभाले हैं. अब अगला politician कौन है जिसके बारे में?
एक तो है, but I can't disclose the name, but I would like to write a political biography on that another politician who is as famous or even more famous than this Naveen Patnaik. And but if I find time from my regular work,
as a reader, I'll wish that you find time, you take sabbatical, you go on leave, but please keep writing. Bahut shukriya aapka kitabwala ke is episode ka hissa banne ke liye. Naveen Patnaik par ye kitab jise likha hai Ruben Banerjee ne, publish kiya hai Juggernaut Books ne, aur hardbound ki keemat to 599 rupaye hai. Kya paperback mein bhi hai ye? Paperback aane wala hai aur ebook to available hai, aur Juggernaut ke app par bhi ye किताब होगी ही. एज अ पॉलिटिकल साइंस का स्टूडेंट, एज अ की लर्नर, ऑब्जर्वर, जो भी कह लीजिए, मुझे ये किताब बहुत पसंद आई एंड आई हाईली रिकमेंड इट. और इसीलिए मैंने रूबेन साहब से दरख्वास्त की आने की. ही वाज बिट अप्रेंसिव कि यार मैं आई एम नॉट दैट कंफर्टेबल इन हिंदी. मैंने कहा जबान उतना महत्व नहीं रखती है जितना कॉन्टेंट रखता है. और आप में से जो लोग अंग्रेज़ी में बहुत सहज नहीं हैं उनको भी मैं रिकमेंड करूँगा कि बहुत ही सिंपल लैंग्वेज है, बहुत जार्गन नहीं है और नरेशन बहुत ही दिलचस्प है, किस्सों से भरपूर है. आपको लगेगा कि आप सदैव वहाँ पहुँच गए हैं. एक लंबी डाइनिंग टेबल है जिसके एक किनारे नवीन पटनायक बैठे हुए हैं घर के कपड़ों में, सामने ब्लैक कॉफ़ी है, हाथ में सिगरेट है और टीवी पे नतीजे देख रहे हैं. फिर शाम के धुंधलके में कपड़े बदलते हैं और एक टैक्सी में टीवी स्टूडियोज़ के राउंड लगाते हैं. या रात है, थाई करी है और वो ग्राउस की बॉटल का एक पैग है और फिर दरवाज़ा खोलते हुए नवीन पटनायक हैं. या अपने दफ्तर में बैठे नवीन पटनायक हैं जिनके एक फ्लोर नीचे एक मंत्री है जो अपने सैक होने की खबर टीवी पर देखता है. या रैलियों में जाते नवीन पटनायक, ऐसे बहुत सारे नज़ारे गंजम सैल्यूट से लेके और वो बीच के किनारे और स्विमिंग पूल के किनारे तक के, जिनके बारे में किताब में तफसील से बताया गया है. और सिर्फ अच्छा अच्छा नहीं बताया गया है, सिर्फ बुरा बुरा नहीं बताया गया है, क्योंकि जीवन ऐसा ही होता है, नेताओं का भी और हमारा भी ऐसा बताया गया. ललन टॉप को किताबवाला में कौन सी किताब और फीचर करनी चाहिए आप कमेंट बॉक्स में लिखकर बता सकते हैं. इस बातचीत के बारे में भी अपनी राय जरूर दीजिएगा. शुक्रिया.